pursue him intently. Psalm 27 verses 4 and 8. One thing I have desired of the Lord, that will I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. When you said, seek my face, my heart said to you, your face, Lord, I will seek. Another important aspect of knowing God intimately is to pursue him intently. That is to pursue him with laser sharp focus, avoiding all distractions and avoiding things that may want to take the place of God or that put demands on us in order to distract us. To pursue God with focus, with intently, keeping our eyes focused on him. Like the psalmist here in Psalm 27, David said, one thing I seek, one thing I'm going to go after. I want to gaze upon the beauty of the Lord. I want to inquire in his temple. When God invited me, saying, seek my face, David said, his response was, my heart said, your face, Lord, I will seek. That means, God, that's my focus. I'm going after that. Now, as people, of course, we have responsibilities in this world. Of course, there are things that we enjoy in doing or engaging with in this world. Maybe you enjoy your work. Maybe and that's a good thing. Maybe you enjoy certain things in this life. You like to travel. You like great food. You like to visit places. You like to spend time with people. And all of those things are good. They're not bad in themselves. And we need to engage. We need to enjoy. But when we talk about pursuing God, our pursuit of God has to be so intent that even though we are giving time for other things and we are enjoying the other things of life, somehow this, it takes precedence and is in a place where nothing else is going to rob us of our pursuit of God and rob us of our pursuit of knowing him intimately. Because if we are not careful, other things could displace the place of God. Other things could somehow squeeze out the time, maybe even the passion that we have towards pursuing God intimately and knowing him intimately. So, what we must do is to pursue him intently with focus and guarding that focus so that nothing else will take our place of pursuing God. So, when you and I set aside time to read the Word, it is something we do, like we said yesterday, out of passion because we enjoy it. But it's also something we do with focus. That means I'm not going to let anything else take that time away from me. I'm not going to let anything else take that place of seeking him through his word or seeking him in prayer or seeking him in worship. Of course, we have responsibilities and we do have to give time for those things. We do have things that we want to enjoy and we give time for those things. But our pursuit of God is intent, is focused. It's something that we guard and protect so that we don't let anything else take its place. Like David, we are single-minded about this thing. One thing I desire, one thing I'm going after. I want to know God intimately. Let's pursue him intently so that we can know him intimately. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we ask that you will help us be watchful, be protective about our pursuit of you, that we will pursue you intently with focus and let nothing rob us of that. That like David, we too can say one thing we desire, one thing we are going after. We want to know the beauty of God. We want to know him intimately. We pray this, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.